Welcome to Monday with Michelle on Outlate But Great. I am having to do this video on my phone because my computer monitor has decided to completely die. So I actually had to write this all down because I could not access the topic except for on my phone. But as you know, it's hard to do two applications at once without being a total mess. Okay, so Maya picked our topic this week, and she actually picked it from a viewer's suggestion. The viewer's name or user channel, I should say, is Teofane. And if Teofane, if you're still out there, I would love for you to contact me because I actually looked through our emails to try and find your contact information, and I couldn't find it because I was going to ask you if you wanted to be a guest. So if you are watching this still, if you're still around, if you could please email me at outlatebutgreat@yahoo.com. Okay, so the topic that he suggested was, A while ago, a gay couple was attacked, brutally beaten, and robbed by a mob in Philadelphia. The crime was solved not by the police, but through an intensely focused grassroots movement on Twitter. The perpetrators of this vicious crime were revealed to be white, upwardly mobile, and all former classmates of a local Catholic high school. Though some arrests are expected, the sad fact is that violence against LGBT people, I'm telling you, one day I actually will be able to say those four letters together, is not considered a crime in Philadelphia. And I think what he meant to say was like not considered a hate crime or a special type of crime. Obviously, violence against people is a crime in general. Okay. How does the fear of anti-LGBT violence affect your life? Do you feel that mainstream media does enough to bring these crimes to our society's attention? How do you think our community should deal with these states whose hate crime legislation does not include LGBT people, perhaps boycotts or social media campaigns? Okay, well, to answer the first question, I'm sure if you have not heard about this story, I guess this, at this point, this must have happened, I think, in 2000, and it was either last year or late the year before, I'm not exactly sure, but it's an awful thing. It's an awful thing when anybody gets brutally attacked and killed or, you know, anything like this. It's awful. It's just absolutely awful. So they're asking, do I have any fear of hate crime against me because I'm in the LGBT community? And I actually don't. I try very hard to walk around in the present and not put a lot of energy into negative things. And I just, you know, you can't really help what happens to you when it comes to some really strange, bizarre occurrence like that. So walking around worrying about it all the time is certainly not going to help matters. You know what I mean? However, I don't walk around with a big sign on my, you know, forehead. And, you know, I sometimes have LGBT-related t-shirts on and stuff like this. But I've never gotten any flack or I've never... so far, I have never heard anything negative from anybody about it. So it's not something that I am too worried about. You know what I mean? I mean, of course, I don't want anything like that to ever happen to me or anybody else that I care about or anybody else, period. But I just, I try not to walk around worrying about that kind of thing. And so it says, do you feel that the mainstream media does enough to bring these crimes to our attention? Well, you do hear a lot about this when it happens. And so I guess it just depends on who you ask and where you live, you know. But I can tell you that when stuff like this does happen around here, we do hear about it in our media. And I do hear about a lot of other places that it's happened. How do you think the community should deal with the states? Well, I mean, what are you going to do? You know, it's state legislation. Other than not living in a state where you feel like you're not protected, I mean, but who is going to move just based on that? I mean, hardly anybody that I know would do that. You know, you live where you live and you just are hoping and voting as often as is possible for legislation to pass. But I mean, you really, nothing you're going to do personally, like boycotts or whatever, I mean, I can't honestly see how that would affect a state legislation, because it's not a product, you know what I mean? It's not something that you can stop buying or stop subscribing to, or, you know what I mean? I don't know how boycotts would actually work in this instance. You know, you just have to, for me, I just think that you just have to keep hoping that our society is going to keep evolving, and that eventually all states will have the proper legislation, and, you know, also hoping that eventually these kind of crimes will stop. But, I'm not stupid. Obviously, crime is going to exist probably for a long time. It always has been around. It probably always will be around. Because people, in my opinion, are at different evolutionary stages in their lifetimes. I believe in multiple lifetimes. And so if you are a very new soul or not quite evolved, you know, you're going to be someone who would beat up somebody or hurt somebody else who was not like you, or, you know, that's a whole different video anyway. But I'm not sure how to go about making it such that all states have this legislation other than vote where you live. You know, that's our strongest voice that we have. All right, well, wish me luck, because I'm going to try to directly upload this to our YouTube, because I have no computer now to do this. And so if you're watching this, I've somehow managed to do this. I've done it one time other than this, so hopefully I can remember how to do it. And hopefully my monitor will be here any day. We went to Best Buy to just pick up my monitor, and they were out of like 3 different monitors that we were willing to buy, so I just ordered one online. All right, y'all, chime into this topic, and I hope you have a good week. Peace.